find something you like. Cheaper than the rest.
Me. Please, please, just here. This itching is driving me insane.
Oh. You're James Warren, right?
Yeah, that's me. What do you want? I'm sick, can't you see?
A week ago, a group of people brought an unconscious man to the crematorium. I need to know who those people were.
What makes you think I'd know that?
You got hurt that day. That's why you're in the hospital. The man you were supposed to burn knocked you out and escaped.
Horse feathers. I hit my head. Fell down the stairs.
You were supposed to cremate a man listed as Jack White. He escaped, and now he wants to know what's going on. So tell me, who paid you to burn a man alive?
How do you know about White?
I talked to him. I need names, Warren.
I can't. I say anything. I'm toast.
They'll certainly kill you if they find out Jack White is still alive. I can arrange that.
No, please. No, I didn't ask their names. They're priests, but they ain't from St. Michael's Church, that's for sure. They were talking about the Lord of the Woods or something. Maybe from an old Oakmont church? That's all I know, I swear.
Where can I find this church?
I don't know. Some things in this Borg are best left alone.
It's not much, but thanks. Wasn't that hard after all, was it?
You got what you came for. Now leave me be.
Bye.
Hey, you. No loitering. Only workers are permitted on the premises.
You're handing out supplies for free. That seems awful charitable.
Mr. Carpenter is a pillar of our community, generously donating half of our supplies to the people of Oakmont in their time of need.
I could use some supplies, if you can spare them, that is.
Here, take some medicine.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
I'm looking for work. I heard you might have a job.
Sure. There's a sack of potatoes in the basement of the manor. Go get it. Bring it here, okay?
Got it.
Get a move on, then.
Bye.
Yesterday, we're beating up newcomers. Today, we're high.
Okay.
What's gonna happen tomorrow?
Don't you have work to do?
So, where are the potatoes?
Please, friend, don't take away my food.
Your food? This is stolen. This sack was meant to go to the hungry.
We are the hungry, mister. Me and my family. I have 5 children to feed and nothing to feed them with. Oh, look, we'll starve to death without it. Have a heart.
I don't get it. You can have food for free. The carpenters are distributing it. So why steal?
They'd only give me 1 portion, even though I told them that my wife and kids are too weak to get here.
Don't worry, I get it. Look, hang on to the sack for now. I'll try to work something out for you, okay?
Oh, thank you, mister. K bless you.
You're a lifesaver.
Just don't go anywhere. I'll be back soon. There's a minor issue.
What issue?
Well, the sack was stolen by one of your workers. I tracked him down so he's not going anywhere, but I'm trying to decide what to do with him.
Damn thieves, man, take them.
I'm sure your boss would want to know about it, but I can see you're pretty busy. Tell you what, I'll go talk to him for you.
You're right. I'm needed here. Vera, go see Mr. Graham Carpenter and report the incident. He's upstairs.
Brutus Carpenter, I presume.
Yes, that's right. Did you bring... I'm very hungry.
No, sorry.
Well, move on then.
Bye. Huh. Now, weren't you the one who called Robert an ape lover, Brutus? This has been empty for years. Seems someone believes eternal life comes in a bottle.
What you making, kid?
Mr. Carpenter?
Yes, Graham Carpenter. How can I help?
One of your workers is a thief. Stole a sack of potatoes.
Oh. I do hope my people haven't taken it into their own hands.
Not yet. Is there a way to solve this peacefully? Guy has a hungry family. That's why he stole.
I won't punish a man for trying to feed his family. Why didn't he simply ask me for more food? Tell him he can keep what he stole. If he needs more, let him come back. It may be that he'll need medicine, too. Can you give him this? It's not much, but it'll help.
No offense, but why such generosity all of a sudden? I mean, this distribution of supplies.
I hope to set an example for the other influential families of Oakmont. Together we can make our city a better place. Besides, after the incident with the poisoned fish, people were left with nothing to eat. I had to take action to prevent starvation.
Thank you. I thought Brutus was the head of the Carpenter family. Something changed?
Oh, no, not at all. My father's still in charge. I've simply taken on some of his responsibilities. He's past his prime and needs more rest.
The mask. Why do you wear it?
A war wound. I prefer not to discuss it, if you don't mind.
Goodbye. I've seen this face before. Paris, December 1918. Right after the guns stopped firing.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned.
You don't get these for staying in your foxhole.
Something wrong.
Don't you have work to do?
Something wrong.
What's your problem?
Me again. Hey, you can relax. Everything's been taken care of. The sack is yours.
Oh, bless you, sir. My little ones will eat today because of you.
Look, I talked to Carpenter about your situation. He said to come by whenever you've a need. He'll do right by your family.
Really? I didn't know Mr. Carpenter was so generous. That family sure has changed. Thank you again, friend.
You said the Carpenters have changed. What were they like before? Hey, you can shoot straight with me. It's all right. We'll keep it between us.
Worse. A lot worse. Criminals and murderers. Rumors are their boss, Brutus, defiled several women and got away scot-free. Terrible. People called them a grand family. Their word is law in Oakmont, along with the Throgmortons and Blackwoods. Tread carefully with them.
Hey, listen. I've got a surprise for you.
A surprise? Okay. What is it?
Carpenter wanted me to give you this.
Kay, bless him and his generosity. Please, send him my thanks.
Fresh fish. Just caught, mister. Burn your eyes. Thank you.
Something's chewed this one up real bad. Ah, now that's a familiar smell. Like your dead skunk. This is in good shape and ready to use.
Make sure you get every scrap. We don't want anyone reading these while we're down there. Take them to the crematorium. We'll destroy them before we dive.
Don't wait. I'll catch up to you.
Stars are aligned, and a new turn of the cycle begins. The time has come to return to the mother's womb, and we shall be reborn, brothers and sisters.
Let's get a handle on what actually...
The stars are aligned, and a new turn of the cycle begins. The time has come to return to the mother's womb. Make sure you get every scrap. We don't want anyone reading these while we're down there. Take them to the crematorium. We'll destroy them.
Don't wait. I'll catch up to you.
A group of fanatics based in the Redemption Church got rid of several bodies, took all the documents they could, and dived.
Thank you.
Why are you here? You look like a fresh wound.
I'm here to put an end to this madness, starting with you.
It will gain you nothing. Strike us down and many more will rise, fresh from the fecund mother's womb, slick, naked, yet burgeoning with strength. Our eyes infest this city, our hands too. We fill young Graham with our words, and soon he will be hollow.
What was that about young Graham?
His house is divided. It cannot stand. The young will succeed the old, as new shoots rise from decay. Our growth shall choke the sun. The veins we open will seed crimson blossoms. The fecund mother grants new life. You should have stayed above.
A familiar smell. Like your dead skunk.
What you making, kid? Got anything to eat?
Are you my mommy?
Where's my mom?
Thank you.
Something's chewed this one up real bad. Ah, now that's a familiar smell. Like your dead skunk. I know who's behind the attempt on your life, Mr. Carpenter.
And? Don't make me wait, kid.
First, I want to know what your plans are for when you resume as head of the family.
Everything will go back to how it was before. Tradition exists for a reason, kid. Besides, it's none of your damn business.
It was your son, Graham. He got mixed up with some kind of cult. They helped him to create your doubles.
My son? You'd better be sure about this.
I am. He paid for your cremation. I found this letter in the cultist's lair. There's no doubt it was him.
Graham was in cahoots with these wackos? That's hard to take in. I mean, we've had our differences, but this...
I'm sorry, Mr. Carpenter. Like, I don't mean to be rude, but there's still the matter of smuggling my client out of Oakmont.
Right. Okay, kid. You've done well. I'll keep my end of the bargain. Your man will leave the Borg tomorrow night. Tell him to be ready.
Thank you.
Whoa, what gives?
Yeah, a little top blackmail, quantity.
A little larceny,
so much for quality. Even my gear's in better shape.
Dump this garbage. Papa Brute will be here any minute.
The blood dried not too long ago. This stain's almost gone.
You like it here, newcomer?
I can't imagine it ended well for whoever lost all this
blood. No one leaves Oakmont nowadays.
Choose wisely.
It's done, Fred. The carpenters will be getting in touch soon. Now, do you have something for me?
Oh, perfect. All right, listen up. I've arranged a meeting with a certain high-ranking member of the EOD. His name is Ebonote Blackwood.
Blackwood, huh? Yeah, I may have run into him once or twice.
If the Order knows something, it's a good bet that Ebonote does too. If they have your professor, he knows where she's being kept. I'll give you the address of the meeting place. He'll be expecting me, not you. So keep your wits about you.
All right. Thanks, Fred. Good luck and safe travels.
Thanks. I'll need it.
Please help a fella out.
I'll take anything you got.